The people of St. Lucia said their final goodbyes to a national hero, a true artist, family man, God-fearing and dedicated citizen. Born October 24, 1927 in Castries to Gerald and Louisa St. Omer, a legacy was created. Who knew at that time Sir Dunstan St. Omer would have become such an inspiration to all? Sir Dunstan painted his first mural at the altar of Our Lady's Chapel at Le Clery. He went on to paint several more throughout the island, drawing acclaim and criticism for his depictions of black divinity. He was most famously known for designing the national flag of St. Lucia. Sir Dunstan's work inspired an art movement. In 2007, the Folk Research Center declared him a national cultural hero.
Through the church, the FRC, and his cultural involvement and writings, to enlighten the St. Lucia Catholic Church, that is to encourage the people to worship God in the image of the Creole language.
In tribute after tribute, his work, persona, and soul was honored. The congregation was reminded of his many accomplishments and accolades, and his life was celebrated.
It is never easy to accept or mourn the passing of a friend. But when that friend has grown to stature, become a legend in his lifetime, where does mourning pause and eulogy begin? It is also pointless to repeat the several well-known anecdotes regarded in journals and in conferences, punctually over the past 2 weeks, which some of you by now have committed to memory.
Mr. Dixon reminded the nation that though St. Lucia has lost a true cultural giant, his legacy will live on to continue inspiring young artists. Sir Dunstan was married to Cynthia St. Croix, and together they had 9 children, all of whom became artists in their own right. He died at the age of 87 on May 5, 2015, and was honored with an official funeral on Wednesday at the Cathedral. His body was laid to rest at the Shock Cemetery. Among those present for the service were the Governor-General Dame Paulette Louise and Prime Minister Dr. Kenny Anthony. For the DBS News World, I am Jenna Anne Gaston.